Hi, I'm Steve Jones, and I'm going to tell you who invented the ruler. Well, which ruler is the question? First of all, the ancients used all of the traditional things like spans and cubits, that is, the distance from this side of your thumb to that end of your finger, the length of the end of your fingers to the elbow, the length of your foot, the height of a man. These are all traditional rulers. But unfortunately, they're not very accurate because some people are 2 meters tall and some people are 1 meter 50. Some people have small hands, some people have big hands. So typically, the French assembly decided in 1791, over 200 years ago, that they would define distance absolutely, and they called it a meter. And it was 1/10 millionth of the distance from the pole to the equator on a line running through Paris. Now, in 1791, that was a very difficult thing to measure, but they measured it. And in 1801, it was made the compulsory measure for everything. So if you were a butcher and you wanted to give somebody a cubit, that is the length here, of meat, sorry, it had to be half a meter. This measure continued. There was a standard meter kept in a very special place in Paris for 200 years. But it wasn't very practical. So eventually they redefined it in terms of the wavelength of light. But even that was then superseded by the present definition, which came in October 1983, which is the distance traveled by light in vacuo, that is when there's no air or anything else, in 1 divided by 299792458 seconds. That's 1,299,792,458th of a second. That's a long time.